Good afternoon, everyone, and happy Fresh Friday. This week's feature is the University of Kentucky Research and Education Center out in Princeton, Kentucky. If you want to read a little bit about what they do, you can check out our post from 11 today. But we recently got to go out there and pick some delicious apples from their research farm. We're going to be using these apples today to make a delicious pumpkin and apple baked oatmeal. I'm telling you, this is going to change your breakfast game. We're going to start off by chopping up one apple and set that off to the side. In a separate bowl, we're going to add in some of our pumpkin puree. If you remember, we made this last week. If you missed our video, it is just a simple pumpkin puree that can replace what you get at the store, and it's made with local pumpkins. We're also going to add in some milk, a little bit of local maple syrup. We're going to add a touch of vanilla, and then one egg, and we're gonna give this a really good whisk. Make sure everything gets combined fully, all of the pumpkin puree gets brought up and incorporated, and our egg is fully broken up. Then we're going to add in our chopped up apples, our rolled oats, some baking powder, a little bit of kosher salt, and then all of our fall spices. So some ground cinnamon, a little bit of ground ginger, some ground allspice, and ground clove. We'll give this a really nice mix. And then similar to last week's recipe where we roll the cookie dough in a sugar mixture, in a small bowl, we're going to combine together some granulated sugar and just a little bit of cinnamon. We'll mix this up, and this is going to be spread on top of the baked oatmeal before it goes in the oven. We're going to add our oatmeal to a lightly greased baking dish and then top it with our cinnamon sugar mixture, making sure to sprinkle this all over and get every little crevice. This will go in the oven at 350 degrees for about 30 to 35 minutes, making sure that the center is completely set and there is no jiggle. If there is, just keep it in for a little bit longer and pull it out. We're gonna let it rest for 10 minutes to set up a little bit, and it is ready to enjoy. Does this not look so delicious? It is going to be perfect for those chilly fall mornings that I'm sure are coming very soon. But even right now, this is absolutely delicious. I'm gonna top this with just a little bit of local maple syrup, a little bit of some powdered sugar, and it is ready to enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. We hope you give this recipe a try. Be sure to read our post today at 11 about the University of Kentucky Research and Education Center and check out why we got these gorgeous apples. Thank you so much, and we will see you next week. Bye!